When it comes to behavior management with children with FASD, we need to change our thinking from discipline to redirecting or reteaching. Difficult behaviors are often a symptom of FASD rather than willful defiance. Remember, it's can't behave, not won't behave. If you are caring for a child with FASD, try these strategies to manage their behaviors by changing their environment. Maintain firm rules that are consistently reinforced. Letting things slide every so often will lead the child to feel confused about what is expected of them. When your child breaks a rule, don't engage in debate or negotiation about this. Emotional rewards work better than a token or a treat. Try a smile, hug, or saying, "I'm proud of you." Avoid making threats that you are not prepared to follow through on. Children with FASD can take things literally and will be waiting for it to happen. Limit choices to only two or three options. Too many options can be overwhelming or difficult to understand for the child. Also, make sure the options are something you are prepared to follow through on. If your child is often acting out in anger, have a safe place for them to express their anger physically. For example, they can go to the basement and hit a punching bag. Avoid using natural or logical consequences, as the child is not likely to understand this on their own. Take the time to explain how the consequence is connected to the behavior. For example, you punched a hole in the wall, so now you are going to help me patch it up. Be careful not to get hooked into your child's behavior. Walk away if you need to and come back when everybody is calm. If you know your child's triggers, try to put something into place to avoid the behavior. For example, if you know your child becomes upset during a certain transition, try using a visual schedule or a countdown to warn the child that the activity is coming up. Practice or role-play the behaviors you would like to see your child do. Repetition will help the child store this into their long-term memory. Give a signal like thumbs up or thumbs down to let your child know if they are engaging in appropriate behavior. This is a great way to help your child without being too intrusive. Post the rules in your home and refer to them often. Try to keep them simple and don't have too many at a time to ensure the child is able to understand and not become overwhelmed. Strategies that may not work. Reward systems, such as tokens, stickers, money, and star charts. It's difficult for a child to understand the concept of future earning and cause and effect. Timeouts. Timeouts can be used to give breaks or cool down time, but it is unlikely to prevent the behavior from happening in the future. Taking things away, like a child's phone after they broke a curfew, is not going to teach the child to come home on time. Grounding or loss of privileges. Again, this does not teach the child the way you want them to behave next time. Also, due to short-term memory issues, it may be difficult for the child to associate the grounding with their previous behavior. Contracts often set children with FASD up to fail, as they are making promises they can't follow through on. Long-term and delayed consequences, for example, if you don't behave, we're not going to the hockey game on Friday. There's just too much time between the behavior and the consequence. Check out this booklet, FASD Strategies, Not Solutions, for more strategies to use with your child with FASD.